All right, guys, thanks for hanging around to the end of this video. So I'm gonna take a couple minutes just to quickly run through why we made Unison. So about a month ago, I was working on a track. It was kind of a pop style deep house track. And I wanted to layer in an analog bass with my main bass. And in doing that, I realized two things, and those two things led to wanting to create Unison. So the first thing I realized was when you load up synths from a company like Arturia, they have tons of really cool analog inspired synths, right? And I have one pulled up right here. This is the Modular V. I realized that preset surfing and trying to find a feeling was really, really hit or miss for a modern genre, like a deep house genre. And I realized, hey, that's probably gonna ring true to most producers who are working in more, you know, contemporary modern genres. And that makes sense, right? When these old school synths like a Moog or a Juno or Modular V came out, those genres didn't even exist. The second thing I realized was once you did find a preset or you tweaked a preset or made one from scratch, with these really analog inspired synths, it almost was too much analog flavor, if that makes sense. Sometimes you just want a little bit of that character to make things less digital. And if you go too far past that point, it starts to change the whole flavor, vibe, and character of your track. And that's not what I wanted to do. So that was the second kind of guiding light for the pack, Unison. Now, what we did with Unison was we named things, we organized things in a way that's gonna make sense to a modern producer producing modern genres. So if we go down to the Unison pack here, we can see that there are basses, chords, some drums, keys, leads, pads, plucks, and polyphonic synths. Now, take the bass category for instance. We have a top bass, we have a very analog Reese, which is gonna sound like a Reese bass for, you know, modern genre of music like hip hop, trap, feature bass, but it has that analog flavor. Right, but not so much that it's gonna overtake your track. Now, if we go down into the chord section, a lot of great stuff for future bass, for progressive house, any type of, you know, big saw or square style. So I'm just gonna pick one at random here. We're gonna try out chord pitch wobble. All right, so I'm not gonna run through each preset. I just wanted to give you guys a better look to what's included in Unison. Here's all the basses that we have, the chords, different drums, keys, leads, pads, plucks, and polysynths. All right, thank you for checking out this video, guys. If you have any questions or comments about Unison, let me know in the comments below or reach out via email. I'll try to help you out. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.